Hey all, welcome to homeschool. We are with the chapter Magnetic Effect of Electric Current. See, in our previous videos, we have discussed about the basic aspects of magnetic field, that is the magnetic field lines, everything we discussed. And later, we went to a concept called magnetic effect due to a current carrying conductor, right? Conductor can be of various shapes. So in my previous video, if the conductor was a straight conductor, how does the magnetic field generated? What was the direction of magnetic field? You know, when current was carried in a straight conductor, magnetic field generated will look like concentric circles. Isn't it? Where the direction of magnetic field can be found with the help of Maxwell's right hand thumb rule. Okay, so Maxwell said that imagine the direction of current is the direction of your thumb, and the curled fingers, actually these fingers are perpendicular to the direction of current. So these curled fingers indicate the direction of magnetic field. That was our right hand thumb rule. So using this, according to a direction of current, magnetic field direction can be found, right? So all those things we discussed in our previous video. Now, if the conducting wire is in a circular loop, okay, then how does a magnetic field look like? What are the properties of such a magnetic field? What happens for the circular loop when magnetic field is generated? You know, all these things we are going to discuss in today's video. Clear, everybody? So what is the motto of a session? We are going to discuss all things about magnetic field produced when current is flowing in a circular loop. So what do you mean by a circular loop? Say for example, this is the wire. See, if the wire is something like this, we say it is straight, right? The wire is straight, the conductor is straight. If the wire is in this particular shape, you know, this is what we call circular loop. So we have a copper wire, that is a conductor, which is there in this particular shape, okay, in the form of a circular loop. Say, when the conductor is in this particular shape, if I allow current to pass through this particular wire, you know, how does the magnetic field generated and how does the magnetic field looks like, right? That's what we are going to study in this particular session. Fine. First and foremost, let me draw a circular loop conductor. Okay, say if this is the circular loop, okay, and one end of a loop I connect to a positive terminal of a battery, another end of a loop I connect to a negative end of a battery. Okay, so that current definitely flows from positive to negative. Say, imagine this is the direction of current flowing in a circular loop. So now, whenever current flows in a conductor, you know, Hans Oersted is the scientist who told that magnetic field will get generated. Whatever may be the shape of a conductor, guys. It may be a straight conductor, it may be a circular loop, or it may be in the form of a solenoid. Whenever current flows in a conductor, what gets generated? Magic gets generated. What is that magic? Magnetic field gets generated. Okay, so definitely here also magnetic field gets generated. But how does the magnetic field looks like? Say in case of straight conductor, magnetic field looked like concentric circles, isn't it? Now in what shape does a magnetic field or field lines look like in this particular case? Can you be able to imagine? Say, circular loop is nothing but collection of many straight lines.
Do you agree with this? You know, this is a circular loop which has so many points, guys, which has so many points, infinite points you have in this. A circle will have infinite points. Yes or no? Say, if I join few of the points, you know, I'll join a few of the points, something like this. See? Now, the same circular loop, I'm drawing it like this. See here, the circular loop is nothing but collection of so many straight lines. Yes or no? See, I'll break a circular loop here. Okay, say when I break it at certain points, I get small, small straight lines. So what I can conclude here is, one point try to remember, circular loop is a collection of many straight lines. Many straight lines. This is the first point that you have to remember, guys. Okay. Circular loop is a collection of so many straight lines. Say many points I join and I'll put it as a straight line. Say some of the points here I joined and I took it as a straight line. Some of the points I joined here I took it as a straight line. Like that, you know, many straight lines combine in the form of a circle and makes a circular loop. Okay, so now consider each and every straight line. Say this is one straight line, this is another straight line. Say consider any one straight line. Okay, say I consider this straight line. See, current is passed. Current is passed in this direction, say positive to negative. Okay, don't worry about the direction of current now. Just consider this particular straight line. Okay. And you know, in our previous video, you studied that when current is moving in a straight line, how does the magnetic field look like? Concentric circles. Yes or no? Here also same case. See, I consider this straight line. When current flows through it, how does my magnetic field look like? You know, concentric circles. When I consider this straight line, you know, I consider this straight line. Okay, and how does the magnetic field looks like? Concentric circles. At every point of a loop you take, at every point, at every straight line, say this is another straight line. How does the magnetic field look like? Concentric circles. I consider this point. This is also one of the straight line, right? At this particular point, how does the magnetic field look like? Concentric circles. Okay, you take any point in a loop. Okay, any point is nothing but the point in a straight line, right? So since the loop is made up of so many straight lines, you know, at every point the magnetic field appears in the form of concentric circles. So how does a magnetic field look like in a circular loop, guys? In concentric circles. Okay, so the next point I would like to write here is, at every point in a circular loop, magnetic field generated looks like concentric circles. Very important points. You know, if you can write down point wise, it's very easy for you all to revise this. Okay, so better note all these points in your book. Fine. So two points we got to know. First thing is, the circular loop can be divided into so many straight lines. See, so many straight lines in the form of this shape, when joined, you get circular loop. Yes or no? So circular loop is a collection of many straight lines. So when a current is passed through such straight lines, obviously in our previous video we studied that when current was flowing in a straight line, it appears, magnetic field appears in the form of circular loops. Here also same thing. At every point in a circular loop, you know, the magnetic field generated will appear in the form of circular loops only. Okay, fine. So two things are very, very clear for us. Now, how do you find the direction of magnetic field in this case? So my big question here is, how do you find the direction of magnetic field? Direction of magnetic field, MF in the sense magnetic field. Okay. We all very well know that direction of magnetic field depends on the direction of current. Definitely. So the very first point you need to remember is direction of magnetic field depends on the direction of current. Depends on the direction of current. And now, let us try to find out what is the direction of these magnetic fields that is appearing in the form of concentric circles. Okay, say at every point of a loop, you have magnetic field in the form of concentric circles. Okay, but how is this magnetic field moving? In which direction the magnetic field moving? Whether it is moving in clockwise direction or is it moving in anti-clockwise direction? So how do you find out? That is what we are going to discuss now. Hey guys, look carefully and try to understand the concept. Clear? See here, this is a loop and you know from positive terminal you have to show the direction of current. Yes or no? Current is moving in this direction. Can you tell me, is this direction of current clockwise or anti-clockwise? Clockwise or anti-clockwise? See, it's moving like this. How does a clock move? Something like this, right? So this is a clockwise direction. Got to know? I told you the direction of magnetic field depends on the direction of current. So here, current is moving in a clockwise direction. Okay, so we have two cases here. Case one. In a case one, current flows in a clockwise direction. Okay, clockwise direction. So I consider current flowing in a clockwise direction. Then what is the direction of magnetic field? Okay, see, I told you the loop is nothing but the collection of straight lines only. The loop is nothing but collection of straight lines only, right? So this is one straight line, this is another straight line, this is the third straight line, this is fourth straight line, right? So many, infinite number of straight lines. Okay, so when a current was moving in this direction, definitely at every straight line, at every point, what do you observe? Concentric circles, magnetic field gets generated in concentric circles. Okay, say I'll put concentric circles at this point and let me consider this point here. Concentric circles are produced. At every point it is produced, but I am just taking two points, this side and this side. Okay, and you know, the loop I divide into two parts. This is left hand side of a loop. Yes or no? So this is left hand side of a loop and this part is a right hand side of a loop. Yes or no? There are two sides for a loop. One is left side of a loop, right side of a loop. Okay, and now apply right hand thumb rule to decide the direction of magnetic field. Okay, see, since the loop is made up of so many straight lines, at every straight line, at every point, concentric circles are appearing. To find the direction of magnetic field in case of straight line conductor, you used right hand thumb rule. Yes or no? Same thing here. Can't you use right hand thumb rule to find the direction? So what is the direction of current, guys? This is what, right? So this is my thumb. What is the direction of current? Say this is the thumb. So here, this is the straight conductor. This is the straight conductor. Thumb shows the direction of current. And what is the direction of magnetic field? Something like this, no? My fingers are curling like this. Is it a clockwise direction or anti-clockwise direction? clockwise in the sense this one, anti-clockwise is opposite, yes or no? So magnetic field lines are actually moving in this direction, yes or no? See my fingers. So this is a thumb, direction of current. Direction of current is this way. So thumb I will place upside. See the direction of my curled fingers. How is it moving? In this direction. Isn't it? In this direction. So anti-clockwise. The direction of magnetic field is anti-clockwise. Okay. So let me note down that point now. Okay. So in left hand side of a loop, left hand side of a loop, the direction of magnetic field is anti-clockwise. Anti-clockwise. Magnetic field is moving in anti-clockwise direction. See, like this. Anti-clockwise. So this is the thumb. Okay, exactly straight. So like this, my fingers are moving anti-clockwise. This is an anti-clockwise direction. Okay, fine. And now, coming to the right hand side. Okay, let me consider this particular straight line. You see the direction of current here. Something like this, downward direction. Is it? No, downward direction. Say my thumb, current direction is downwards in this side, right hand side. Okay, so don't worry about the center and all. Okay, left hand side, throughout the left hand side, current direction is from bottom to up. But the moment you come to the right hand side of a loop, the current direction is from top to bottom. Isn't it? So my thumb is the direction of a current. Thumb I'll place here. So my curled fingers, how are they moving? Clockwise or anti-clockwise? Say like this. It is moving like this. Is that no? Clockwise direction. This is clockwise direction. See, my thumb I'll place exactly downwards. Okay. That indicates the direction of current. See once again my fingers. So how are they curling? How are they curling? This direction. Okay. This direction. So this is a clockwise direction. Yes or no? So what do I write here? In right hand side of a loop. Right hand side of a loop, direction of magnetic field is clockwise. Direction of magnetic field is clockwise. Clear everybody? Okay. So when the current, case one, what is the case one? Current is flowing in a clockwise direction. Basically the current direction is clockwise. Only then, in case of left hand side, the direction of magnetic field would be anti-clockwise. But in case of right hand side of a loop, the direction of magnetic field would be what? Clockwise. Clockwise. Okay. See, down. Bottom to top to bottom, the current is flowing. So thumb is faced at the bottom. So how are the magnetic field lines moving? Like this. Clockwise. Okay. Where? In RHS. But in LHS, how are my lines moving? How are my lines moving? Anti-clockwise. Okay. So this is what the direction of magnetic field in left hand side as well as right hand side when the current is moving in a clockwise direction. So now let us see, if current moves in anti-clockwise direction, what happens? Okay. So let me take a loop. I connect to a battery. Now this is a negative side, this is a positive side. Okay. Now how is the current flowing, guys? From positive side. Current is flowing from this side. So tell me what direction it is, clockwise or anti-clockwise? Anti-clockwise, no? Anti-clockwise. How does the clock move? Like this. Like this. This is clockwise direction. And this is anti-clockwise direction. Okay. So in the previous case, current was moving in clockwise direction. Now the current is moving in anti-clockwise direction. Okay. So this is our case 2. So this is our case 2. What is case 2? If current flows in anti-clockwise direction. anti-clockwise. See, I'm giving you points in detail in a very clear way. Okay, so that you can note it down for the reference. You know, I am very much sure that in your textbook as well as in any kind of video, you will not have this much detailed points. Okay, so better make use of the points so that the whole concept will be clear for you. Right? Okay, so now let us see the case 2. The current is flowing in a anti-clockwise. Whether it flows in a clockwise or anti-clockwise, you know, at every point, what is generated? Magnetic field is generated in concentric circles because the circular loop is nothing but collection of so many straight lines. Okay, fine. And now, can you tell me what is the direction of the magnetic field? Okay, so this is a left hand side of a loop and I break the loop here. So this is right hand side. Okay, so now coming to the left hand side. How is the direction in the left hand side? Top to bottom. You see, the direction of current is top to bottom, guys. Yes or no? So I hold my finger like this. So how is the direction? How is the direction? See, is it clockwise direction? See, I keep my finger downwards. Okay, because current direction is top to bottom in the left hand side. See the direction of my fingers. Clockwise or anti-clockwise? Clockwise or anti-clockwise? Definitely clockwise. Something like this, right? Direction of my fingers is something like this. That means, you know, your magnetic field line direction is something like this. That is, in LHS, the direction of magnetic field is clockwise. So let me write here. In LHS of a loop, direction of magnetic field is clockwise. Okay, because the current is moving from top to bottom in the left hand side of a loop. Coming to the right hand side, in the right hand side the current is moving upwards, yes or no? So I keep my thumb up because the direction of current is up. So how are my fingers moving? They are moving anti-clockwise, right? So they are moving anti-clockwise. So this is the direction, anti-clockwise. Yes or no? Anti-clockwise. So what do I write here? In right hand side of a loop, direction of magnetic field is anti-clockwise. Okay, so these are the points. Try to remember very, very nicely. Okay, so direction of magnetic field totally depends on the direction of current. If the current is moving in a clockwise direction, okay, in case of left hand side of a loop, the direction of magnetic field is what? Anti-clockwise. So how do we find out? We found it out with the help of right hand thumb rule only. Nothing else. We didn't do any magic here. Just with the help of a right hand thumb rule, we could able to find that in left hand side of a loop, okay, direction of magnetic field is anti-clockwise. Okay, and in the right hand side, the direction is clockwise. But when current is flowing in anti-clockwise direction, case 2, it is just opposite. It is just opposite. Okay, just for an easy purpose, just try to remember case 1. Case 1 is what? Current flowing in a forward direction, that is clockwise direction. This is the condition. Okay, if the current flows in a anti-clockwise direction, just make it opposite. Okay, in the case 1, in LHS you have anti-clockwise, but in case 2, in LHS you have clockwise, just opposite. Clear everybody? So this is what the concept of the direction of current, you know, in a circular loop. It purely depends on the direction of current. Again, in left hand side different direction, right hand side of a loop different direction you will have. That's what you will have to remember. Okay, and this much is actually there in your textbook. And after this I will be telling you few more points. Now these points are actually not mentioned in a textbook, but still application based questions can be asked. So better you study this concept also.
I mean the one which I am going to tell you now. Clear? Fine. Everything is wonderful till here. And you know, so much magnetic effect is created in a circular loop. At every point, concentric circles are appearing. So much magnetic field, guys. So much magnetic field that our circular loop itself is becoming a magnet. Definitely, circular loop is what? One copper wire. When a current is flowing through that, at every point, concentric circles of magnetic field is obtained. Wherever magnetic field is there around an object, can't we call that as an magnet? Definitely no. So much magnetic field is created that circular loop itself has become a magnet. Okay. Now, when something is a magnet, it will have two poles. One is a south pole, the other one is a north pole. Then, when a circular loop has become a magnet, then which is a south pole and which is a north pole? Let us have a detailed look at this particular concept. See guys, very interesting. Listen carefully. So, something I wrote it on a board. Just now I told you. So much magnetic effect is created at every point that the whole circular loop itself behaves as a magnet. Okay. So now, the moment you say something is a magnet, it should have two poles. One is a south pole, other one is a north pole. So how do you give poles for this circular loop? Now it has become a magnet. How do you give poles? Okay. Just try to analyze this. See, you have two sides for a loop. One is outside the loop, the other one is inside of a loop. Say this is inner part of a loop. Okay, this particular area is inner part of a loop. And this is outermost part. Okay, so this is outside of the loop and this is inside of the loop. Loop inside. Okay, inside of a loop is also called as face. Okay, so inside of a loop, inner part of a loop is also called as face. Okay, fine. And you see here, say current direction is, when current direction is clockwise. In the first case, you can observe here, current is moving in a clockwise direction, forward direction. Okay, and now in case of LHS, in case of left hand side, what is the direction of magnetic field, guys? It is anti-clockwise. It is anti-clockwise. In case of RHS, what is the direction of current, guys? It is clockwise. We know this. Just now we studied clockwise. Okay, so this is very much clear for us. Okay, and now you just see here. Just try to observe, guys. Okay, current direction is upwards. So I will face my thumb direction upwards. I'm just applying right-hand thumb rule. Okay, and see my fingers, how are they moving from outside to inside, outside to inside? That means, see, this is my thumb, I'll keep it here, upside. Okay, see my fingers, how are they moving? Outside to inside, outside to inside. So, if a magnetic, you all know that in the first video you studied, magnetic, the pole from which magnetic field lines appear, North Pole. Okay, they appear, they start moving from North Pole to South Pole. Yes or no? Say, how are the magnetic field lines moving? Outside to inside. That means, outside part of a loop is North Pole and my fingers are moving inside. That means the field lines are moving inside. That means the face of a loop, inner part of a loop behaves as South Pole. Can you be able to imagine here? You have to visualize the things. You have to imagine the things. Only then you will understand the beauty of a subject here. Okay, see, since the current is moving in the clockwise direction, I kept my thumb like this. And you see the direction of my fingers. From outside, they are going to inside of a loop. So outside, from the side where the magnetic field lines come or arise is a North Pole. And they will end up, they will merge in South Pole. okay, that means fingers are going from outside. Fingers are nothing but my field lines, yes or no? So from outside they are going to inside, in the sense outside region of a loop behaving as a north pole. The face of a loop, that is inside region of a loop, is behaving as a south pole. Okay, so here this is a south pole, outside part is a north pole. Okay, now coming to this side, this side also same situation, guys. This side also same situation, only no thumb. See, current direction is downwards. I keep my thumb down. See my fingers, outside to inside. This is outside. Outside, outside to inside, my fingers are moving. That means outside is a north pole, because that is from where the field lines starts. And where are they moving in? They are moving inside. Where will the field lines end up? They end up in, they will merge up in south pole. Yes or no? So here also, outside region is always a north pole, inside region is always a south pole. When current is flowing in a clockwise direction. Okay, so let me write the points here. So here, outside of a loop, acts as north pole, because our magnetic field lines will emerge from outside. Yes or no? Thumb I'm keeping, fingers are moving from outside. From the side where the magnetic field lines emerge, come, is a north pole. Yes or no? So acts as a north pole. And inside of a loop, that is phase. Inside part is also called as phase. So phase acts as south pole. Okay, guys, clear everybody? Fine. So this is a situation one, actually. Now, if the current moves in a anti-clockwise direction, see here, from here, current is moving in a in this direction, anti-clockwise direction. Now, let us see which part of a loop is acting as a south pole or north pole. Okay, can you be able to visualize? Can you be able to think and visualize yourself? If current direction is anti-clockwise, okay, then see, anti-clockwise, right? Okay, see now, let me go for the right hand side of a loop. Okay, the direction is upwards, so my finger direction is upwards. Fingers are coming from inside to outside. Actually, fingers are coming from inside to outside. So, inside part of a loop, that is the face of a loop, will act as a north pole. Outside part will act as a south pole, guys. Because you see, at this point also, even in this point also, yeah, here you can visualize nicely. You see, in the LHS side, the direction is downwards. I'm keeping my thumb downwards. And how do I move my fingers? Actually, it will come from inside. Say, for example, this is a loop. Okay, see, I'm keeping my thumb like this. From inside, my fingers are coming. From inside to outside, my fingers will come. Okay, so when the current moves in anti-clockwise. So, inside, from that inside part, fingers are coming. Magnetic field lines are coming. So the side from which field lines come is always a north pole. Yes or no? And they will merge in south pole. Got it? So here it is opposite. So outside of a loop, acts as south pole here. Okay? And face of a loop, that is inside of a loop, face of a loop will act as north pole here. North pole. Okay, so this is how you have to decide outside or inside part, like which part of a loop acting as a north pole or south pole. Okay, again, it all depends on the direction of current. If the direction of current is clockwise,
You know, always outside the loop will behave as North Pole. Inside the loop, the face of a loop, the center of a loop will behave as South Pole. If the current is moving in anti-clockwise direction, outside of a loop will behave as South Pole, and inside the center of a loop will behave as a North Pole. Okay, actually this is what we will call it as clock phase rule. We call this as clock phase rule. Anyway, this is not mentioned in your textbook, but it is very, very important for competitive exams that you are going to write in the future after 12th standard. 12th standard, again, this topic reappears where you study more detailed things about clock phase rule. Okay, but anyway, if a question have to be asked in a detailed way or in an application-based way, this concept they may choose and they may frame the questions for you. So better have idea on this also, okay? So when a loop itself has become a magnet, then which side is South Pole, which side is North Pole? Definitely depends on the direction of current, okay? So if the direction of current is clockwise, you know, this is what the North Pole and South Pole. If the direction of current is anti-clockwise, then outside part is South Pole, face of a loop is North Pole, okay? Fine. You know, to remember this in a better way, actually we will tell certain shortcuts here, okay? Observe the shortcuts here. And which direction? Clockwise direction, no? You see here, phase of a loop will be south. See, S means it's also moving in a clockwise, right? If you write S, you know, the direction of S will be there in a clockwise direction, see? Loop current flows in a clockwise direction. Yes, the direction is also clockwise. See, this direction means clockwise only. That means when a current is flowing in a clockwise direction, the loop, the face of a loop, inside part will be behaving as a South Pole. If inside part is behaving as a South Pole, it is understood that outside part will behave as a North Pole, right? So this is a shortcut, guys. So when a current is moving in a clockwise direction, you know, the symbol S also is placed in the form of a clock only, right? If you put arrow mark here at the edges of a S, you know, which direction will it show? How is this arrow marks are showing? They are showing in clockwise direction, right? So face of a loop is behaving as a South Pole when current is moving in a clockwise direction. Shortcut. Okay, if current is moving in a anti-clockwise direction in the sense like this, then you see the face of a loop is behaves as a North Pole. See N, if you put the direction for N, you know, N, if you write it like this, how is this direction shows? Anti-clockwise, right? So inside part of a loop will behave as North Pole when current is moving in an anti-clockwise direction. So the symbols itself will tell. Actually, this is how people remember as shortcuts. Okay, so this is what we call clock phase rule. Anyway, its definition and all is not necessary. Okay, so this is all about deciding the poles of a loop when it behaves as a magnet. Okay, so you can just note it down, all the points in your book for a reference, or take a screenshot. We will go for the next very, very, very important point that can be asked for board examination regarding this concept. Okay, see guys, now we have one important question. Just try to read out the question here. What is the direction of magnetic field at the center of a loop? You know, at this point of a loop, or at this point of a loop, at every point in case of left hand side of a loop, the direction of magnetic field is anticlockwise. Okay. At every point of right hand side of a loop, the direction of magnetic field is clockwise. But what about the direction of magnetic field at the center of a loop, exactly at a center of a loop? What's your answer, guys? The direction is in a straight line. The direction is exactly parallel. You know, it appears, it looks like a straight line. Okay, so what is the answer here? The direction of magnetic field at a center is in straight line. Very, very important. But can you tell me how it appears as a straight line? See, at every point in the right hand side of a loop, left hand side of a loop, it is appearing as concentric circles. Here anti-clockwise direction, here clockwise direction, okay. But exactly at a center, you know, magnetic field lines will appear as straight lines. How is this possible? See, very simple diagram I'm going to show you here. I'll take a very big loop. I'm going to take a very, very, very big loop. Okay, fine. And I'll start drawing a concentric circle. Say, I'll consider this point. This is one straight line. So at this point, I'll start drawing a concentric circles. Again, this side, this is the point I'll consider, and I'll start drawing a concentric circles. That's how the magnetic field gets generated here, right? Okay, say I'm drawing one concentric circle, second one, third one, yes, fourth one, fifth one, sixth one, seventh one. Here also, first one, second one, third one, fourth one, bigger one, you know, it's a time waste to draw a big circle. So I'm ending here. Just inside part I'm considering. Inside part of a loop I'm concentrating. So see, as you come inner part of a loop, bigger and bigger, you see exactly at the center of a loop. You see exactly at the center of a loop. How is your magnetic fields look like? They look like as a straight line. Yes or no? So as the number of concentric circles increases and their size increases, the moment you come at the center and when you visualize it, when you see it, definitely your magnetic field appeared parallel to each other and you know, they move in a straight line. Okay? And at the center, the concentration of magnetic field is very high. The strength of magnetic field is very high. This point also try to remember, at center of a loop, the strength of magnetic field is high. Okay, at the center the magnetic field is very high. And also, the magnetic field lines appear and they move in straight line exactly at the center of a loop. Okay, so now you understood why it looks like a straight line at the center, right? Fine. And now, one more thing try to remember. I think this point is common for whatever the conductor's shape may be. As you increase the amount of current, as the current strength increases, the strength of field lines also increases. Okay, say you start giving more and more current in the circuit, you know, more and more concentric circles gets generated. That means more and more magnetic field is observed. Clear? So this is one point you have to remember every time throughout the chapter. This point have to be fixed in your mind. What is the point? As you increase the strength of current in a circuit, the strength of magnetic field also increases. This is one important point every time should be there in your mind. And one more point, the direction of magnetic field in any conductor depends on the direction of current compulsorily 100%. Yeah, so these two points have to be remembered every time throughout the chapter. Clear? So this is all about the magnetic effect due to a current flowing in a circular loop. So much of concept we studied today. And now let us end the video with a beautiful experimental visual that I am going to show you now.
Hey guys, let us see an experiment regarding magnetic effect of electric current. Initially, we will see how it can be seen in case of straight conductor. See, this is a straight wire when electricity is passing, see electrons, electricity is passing this way, you can observe the magnetic field generated in the form of concentric circles. You can clearly see this. At every point, this magnetic field is generated in concentric circles, and you know, you can visualize it in the form of a cylinder outside a conductor, right? Say always the direction of magnetic field can be shown by the right hand thumb rule, isn't it? We all have discussed enough. Now let us go for seeing magnetic effect in circular loop. Okay, so this is a circular loop setup. Took a wire which is there in a circular form, connected to ammeter. This is a battery and this is a rheostat. Okay, and you can see here they have kept a cardboard where iron powder is spread out. Current is passing this way, anti-clockwise direction, guys. And you see the iron filings, how they will arrange themselves when you actually tap the cardboard, right? You can just imagine how the concentric circles are appearing. See, at this point and this point, concentric circles appeared. At every point of a loop, this kind of concentric circles will appear. We have discussed this also, right? And the direction of each and every concentric circle can be found with the help of right hand thumb rule here also. So we have discussed, in case of right hand side, when current is flowing in anti-clockwise direction, you know, magnetic field appears in anti-clockwise direction, and in case of LHS, that is left hand side, magnetic field direction is clockwise. Okay, so you can clearly visualize, right? See, in this side it is clockwise, this side it is anti-clockwise. Magnetic field direction I'm talking about, right? See how the concentric circles are moving. This is clockwise, this is anti-clockwise. And also you can observe at the center, this is the center of a loop, right? See, at the center the lines are actually looking like a straight line. See, this is purely a straight line, right? So at the center you will have more strength for the magnetic field, as well as, you know, the concentric circles will appear in the form of a straight line, guys. Got it? That's all about magnetic effect due to current in circular loop.